This video is presented by EA Game Changes. Hello guys and welcome to a brand new video. My name is Jovan and I'm the administrator of the Sims Community website, and in this video I'm gonna be showcasing every new thing that's coming your way to the Sims 4 base game for free. So that's right, I got the early alpha copy thanks to EA along with the early access copy for the Sims 4 Eco Lifestyle expansion pack, and let me tell you, there are so many fun new additions that you guys are gonna get your hands on in just a few days after this video gets posted. So I'm not sure about the exact release, but it's coming your way very soon. So we have a whole new revamp of bills and utilities. We have inventory 2.0. We finally get ladders. Objects have also changed when it comes to their information and how much they consume power and water. We also get some other new additions as well. And yeah, how did I even forget to mention that we are finally getting firefighters back in The Sims 4? So, plenty of cool things to explore, but let's begin with the Sims 4 build mode first. So, after I go into build mode, I want to showcase first how much they've changed up the objects when it comes to their information and how much power each item consumes. So, for example, we have this lower quality TV going on over here, and you can see that we now have statistics related to the power consumption rating. So, this is exclusive to objects that, of course, only use electricity. And we also have a statistic related to reliability of that object. So as you can see over here, this TV only uses level 3 of the power consumption rating. And as I go over here and switch up to some higher quality TVs, you will notice that they use a lot more power. And yeah, that their reliability is much higher up there. Of course, when it comes to reliability, this reliability score was basically present before in the game, but now it's actually present. And you can see to yourself how much each item that can get broken, you know, how much reliable it is. But of course, TVs are not the only electrical items in the game. So if I go over here to computers, you can also check out the consumption ratings for these. If I go over to lights, they of course also use the power consumption rating, except for the candles, you know, stuff that can be used off the grid. And when it comes to the objects that use water, well, you can see over here that this shower only has one water consumption rating. But as we go all the way up, there are all these sorts of statistics that they've included, which is really cool. And yeah, as you use higher quality objects, they're gonna be consuming more water and power and will have a much better reliability. So I think that they've also improved upon the off-the-grid lot trait. So it's pretty much the same, but there are a few changes because it all ties down to the new and improved bills and utilities that the Sims team has revamped completely. And because I mentioned off-the-grid over here, the small revamps that they've done for off the grid are not only new, they've also included the off the grid category in build mode. So there are now seven different categories. So first we have plumbing, as you can see over here, and all the items that are functional off the grid. Then we have lighting as well. So only four items if you have the Sims 4 base game only. Of course, this is gonna get much more populated if you have some of the previous packs and the Sims 4 Eco Lifestyle expansion pack as well. We have appliances too, then crafting, outdoor activities, miscellaneous, and show all. So these are all the items that are working off the grid and that do not rely on power and water. So I'm very glad that they've added this category finally, so I can have a full overview of what can work off the grid and what cannot work off the grid. But I'm sure you guys have been wanting to get ladders for a long time, and here they are. So the classic wooden ladder is the new ladder in the game. We get another ladder that rhymes a bit. We get another ladder with the Sims 4 Eco Lifestyle expansion pack. So to place down the ladders, you are gonna have to, I don't think that this is the best home to showcase this feature, but yeah, you can place it indoors if you want. So like this, and Sims are gonna be able to climb up and down. So there we go, we get plenty of presets, so around 16. So here are all the colors that you can check out. I think Wait, let me actually remove the balcony over here. I think that I'm gonna be able to place down the ladders on, you know, multiple stories without having to, you know, place down the ladders first on the first story, then on the second. It can go automatically on top like this. Yeah, it's a bit tricky to place them down, but when it works, it definitely works. So let's see them in action. You have the option to climb them up. You will not be able to slide up, but you will be able to slide down. Here they are, the ladders in action. It might take some time for your Sims to get up, but you can of course choose to slide down very quickly if you want to. So it works like this. Wait. Okay, sis, calm down. Ooh. Oh, there we go. And it works very simple when you place them easily. It took me a while to place these ladders, but like I mentioned, when it works, it absolutely works right. So I've showcased over here that you can place them indoors as well, and it's definitely gonna help you save up some much needed space, especially if you are a player who likes to build tiny homes. And yeah, it's definitely gonna come in handy. Going back to the objects, I wanna also mention that they've improved and added some more descriptions to some of the items. So going back into build mode, I just wanna showcase some of the wallpapers and tell you guys that they've also gone through the changes at adding environmental gains for each wallpaper. So here you can see that this wallpaper has one minor environmental gain. So the higher quality wallpapers there are, the bigger the environmental gain it is. I think that I've also seen that some of these, yeah, so the clean room wallpaper has a green eco footprint, but of course this is not gonna add any new gameplay until you install the Sims 4 Eco Lifestyle expansion pack. One more thing that I forgot to mention that's definitely worth mentioning is the addition to place windows and doors wherever you want using the Alt key on your keyboard. So finally you can move them anywhere left and right, however you want. So the same case goes for doors as well. As you can see over here, you can go all the way to the left or all the way to the right. Of course, there is some interference with the objects inside, but I'm just showcasing it, you know, the ability. One thing that's worth mentioning is the fact that you won't be able to stack windows up against another because, well, that just doesn't work. But you can of course try with bb.moveObjectsOn cheat. So let's try it on. I think that there might be some graphical interference, but yeah, so it might not work the best with BB Move Objects. As you can see, the window is just not properly placed and there can only be like one glass at a time. So let me just remove this one. But yeah, you are finally able to place it on the left and right side however you want. Of course, I'm going a little bit overboard since I've enabled BB Move Objects on. This addition was something that we've been waiting for a long time and it has finally been delivered. Okay, that can actually work. I'm very bad at this, but yeah, the free placement will also be added with this update. So going back into live mode, after you click on your mailbox, now you have, oh my god, the watermark is getting in my way. So now you can show the bills information and see what you can expect from your upcoming bill. So now you have a full breakdown. On the left side, you have a current billing estimate. So you have lot taxes and they are determined based on the value of all objects on the lot and the lot's value. Then you have the power consumption. So the power bill is based on the amount of power consumed and produced while using electrical objects throughout the week. So you can see that I've only gone in the minus one simoleon area because I've only played for like an hour in live mode. So we haven't used too much power in the game. Then we also have water. So the water bill is based on the amount of water consumed and produced while using plumbing objects throughout the week. Then we have some other taxes as well, and they are services, fees, and additional bills that haven't been paid. And last but not least, tax breaks and penalties. So additional taxes and credits potentially derived from various gameplay elements, including lot traits, sim traits, items unlocked, and more. So after I applied the off-the-grid a trade, you know, before recording this video. I got a tax break of 75 simoleons because I was off the grid, and my sim will also gonna be saving up on power and water, and they won't be paying for those specific bills. On the right side, you have management and consumption of power and water. So when it comes to power, it says that I'm gonna be spending around 56 power currencies. I don't know what the actual currency for power in the game is, but yeah, you can choose to auto sell it or store it, but this isn't fully functional if you don't have the Sims 4 Eco Lifestyle installed, so you won't be able to actually store all of that energy until you get that pack. And the same case goes for water as well. But it's very neat that you have this full breakdown of how much power and water you are consuming throughout the day and throughout the week, and you know, and this type of update is adding so much realism into the game, which I completely love. Okay, so this is Jovan from the future, just letting you know that there's one new NPC that's been added with the latest update. I don't know why I forgot to mention, but Repo Men are coming to the base game as well. You might have already heard that we have gotten Repo Men with the Sims 4 Discovery University, and basically they arrived at your home lot if you forget to pay your college tuition on time, and then they come to your home and repossess some of your stuff. So that was only exclusive if you owed some money for the college tuition, but now if you owe some money and don't pay bills in a matter of few days, so after your water and the power is shut down, then Repo Men are gonna show up at your front door, enter your home, and collect some of the valuable items from your home. I'm not sure if they're gonna be working like Repo Men from some of the previous games, where they will find objects that are closely the same value as the money that you owe to the Sim Bank or whatever. But yes, that's another NPC to look forward to. So going back into the game, we now have firefighters. So you've heard that correctly. I'm gonna have to start the fire first, but before we do that, you will see over here in the alarm section that we have a fire alarm. So the alerts smoke alarm. After I place it over here in the kitchen, I'm gonna be alerting firefighters in case, you know, the fire goes down in my lot. So yeah, let's test it out. I've actually purchased the lowest quality stuff, so hopefully something will burn down. Let's see if we have any luck, because she doesn't have a cooking skill at all. It might take me a while for... Okay, there's a fire on the lot. A fire has started nearby. She discovered the fire. Wait. Why isn't the alarm working? Oh man, wait. I don't think... I'm not sure why it's not working in the game. Maybe because it's early alpha or something. But yeah, the firefighters are definitely not showing up. So let me cancel this action and call the fire department myself. Hopefully we're gonna be able to do that, because she's on fire and... Oh, there we go. The alarm has finally been set off. Ah, finally. I thought that was a glitch or something. And firefighters, there they are. Ah, why isn't she running? Ah, there we go. Please help me out. My sim is gonna burn to death. Okay, so this is also helping us out. But yeah, we also received a payment from insurance. Oh my god, so two firefighters actually came down to help. So in case that your lot is completely on fire, you're gonna have two firefighters helping you out. And they're very quick and responsive when it comes to putting out the fire. So, oh my god. God, finally! I've been waiting this for such a long time. I hope that they add more services to the game as the game evolves. So, you know, you can call the fire department if you want, if there isn't any fire on your lot. But let me just tell you, the firefighters are gonna be disappointed if you do so. So let me call the fire department on my phone. Oh my, she needs a shower right away. Thank you for your call. Firefighters are on their way to help right now. So they're gonna be going into your lot, but if they discover that there isn't any fire, yeah, they might get frustrated. So very funny, prankster. There's no fire here. We're going to have to write you a ticket for 500 simoleons for that little lapse in judgment. Yeah, you shouldn't mess with firefighters in the game. I do not recommend that. So, Are you guys ready to check out Inventory 2.0? There we go, finally! So categorizing items in your inventory has never been easier. This is something that the community, including myself, have been wanting to get into the game for such a long time. And now you finally have a clean preview and overview of all of the items in your inventory. So let me break down what's new in the Inventory 2.0. Over here we have the ability to filter items in your inventory, and there are so many categories, including favorites. So you are able to choose favorites for each inventory item, and you can do so by selecting multi-select and selecting the items of your choice and choosing favorite. So let me just unfavorite them quickly and remove this. So if we go over here, you see that there's plenty of categories. So we have new items in your inventory. We have books, so fun books, skill books, and other books. Then we have collectibles, including creature collectibles. Oh my god, the watermark. Decoration collectibles, natural collectibles, and other collectibles as well. Then we have consumables, including food, drinks, and other consumables. Gardening, including flowers, fruits, and vegetables, other gardening. Then we have home and skill, including skill building objects, decoration objects, home objects, and objects for little ones. Special items, which is career and activity items, education items, and story items. Then sim-crafted items, including crafted artwork, crafted books, photographs, woodworks, and other crafts. And then we get scraps as well, which includes parts and junk, and of course miscellaneous. So this is going to help you tremendously to categorize your inventory, especially if you have over 50 items in your inventory and you don't want to go through each and every item to, you know, find the item that you have been looking for. We also get the ability to sort by items in your inventory from ascending to descending, so including name, price, filter, crafted quality, gardening quality, freshness, and rarity. After you choose multi-select over here, you can select multiple items and choose to sell all of them right away. You also have the ability to select all of the items in that specific inventory and sell, you know, all of the items that you have selected. So you can also easily select the items, let's say gardening. So if you have over 50 gardening items in your inventory and you only want to sell those gardening items and not get rid of other ones, you can, you know, select the gardening filter over here, choose multi-select, select all, and sell. And just like that, you got rid of the gardening items in your inventory. So let me remove these filters. So when it comes to the household collections, there isn't anything new or revamped over here. I wish that they did a better breakdown of all of the collectibles and made it more easier for us to see which collectibles can we obtain in the game. But yeah, I'm still very happy about Inventory 2.0. I know that all of us have been wanting to get this for such a long time, and the revamp is finally here in the game. So all of those things that I mentioned regarding, you know, the power consumption rating and some of the wallpapers and trees having a whole new effect on the environment and your Sims' emotional states with the moodlets can be now displayed in the game options. So this is a base game edition, and you can find it over here called Build Mode Items Grant Gameplay Effects. So what it does is, if enabled, architectural elements such as wallpaper, floor patterns, roof materials, doors, windows, pools, fountains, trees, and more will grant effect to gameplay elements like environmental score, eco footprint, and utilities. Check the tooltips for each item to see what effects they might apply. So you can choose to enable it or disable it, and it's gonna make all of the items from build mode that have this new tie-in to the environment and the scores and everything a little less complex. Now, if I go into manage worlds, you are also gonna notice that Willow Creek, Oasis Springs, and Newcrest have some new icons. So the neighborhoods in Willow Creek, Oasis Springs, and Newcrest finally have their neighborhood description, and we finally know the names of each neighborhood. So over here is the Sage Estates, then we get Pendula View, this one is Courtyard Lane, Foundry Cove, and the Crawdad Quarter. If we go into Oasis Springs, we have, so this area is called Skyward Palms, this one is Acquisition Butte, Acquisition Butte, but I don't know if I'm pronouncing it wrong or not. But anyways, this one is Bedrock Strait, this one is Parched Prospect, and this one is Mirage Canyon. If we go into Newcrest, we also have descriptions for those areas as well. So this is Llama Lagoon, this one is Ridgeland Drive, and this one is Bridgeview. So that's it when it comes to the neighborhoods. So yeah, I think that's pretty much it when it comes to all the new additions in the Sims 4 base game. I always get excited for these pre-expansion pack free updates because I know that they deliver a lot of cool new features for free to the base game, and they haven't disappointed me with this one either. So we get ladders, we get a whole revamp of bills and utilities, we get statistics when it comes to power and water usage, we get firefighters finally, and we get the inventory 2.0, some other cool small additions that I mentioned in this video as well. And yeah, let me guys know what you think about the upcoming update for The Sims 4 in the comment section down below. And if you enjoyed this overview video, make sure you hit the thumbs up button and subscribe to this channel for all of the latest news and updates on The Sims franchise. Once again, thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I will talk to you guys in my next one. Bye!